everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. Two teams will need their quarterbacks to step up and lead their offenses on the gridiron today. It's Manning's Giants going up against Bradford's Eagles. So with kickoff approaching, let's send it over to our commentators here this afternoon, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, Larry. It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look live there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the New York Giants and the Philadelphia Eagles. Hi again, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. And you know, Charles, as Larry pointed out in the open, got a couple of great quarterbacks set to square off here this afternoon. That ball's probably going to be flying all over the place, isn't it?
Oh, without a doubt. And the game has never been more quarterback-centric than it is now. And both of these teams have top-flight signal callers.
Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. The return comes from Orleans Darquan. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. So here are the Giants ready to start their initial drive of the game. They'll be led out by a two-time Super Bowl MVP in his 13th year now out of Ole Miss. It's Eli Manning.
And I think that as Eli Manning has progressed as a veteran, you're seeing more and more things added to his game. A little more patience in the pocket, not just looking for the big strike downfield, but willing to take the check down and the easy completion. I think he continues to get better with each year.
Former seventh-round pick, Rashad Jennings. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Jennings spinning past him, and he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. They get six on the pick up there as the drive will continue.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
So it'll be first down here after the run. Throwing on first down is Manning. Over the middle here to Donnell. And he's brought down. 18 yards on the pickup there. And that leads to a New York first down.
The coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Now it's Jennings. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. So here's the starting 11, and the human highlight reel, Odell Beckham Jr., watch out for him.
One of the few guys in the league that gets you and I out of our hotel rooms early to get here for pregame warm-ups and watch him go through his routine. He's absolutely amazing catching the football.
And they still need 8 yards for the first here on second down. Manning to throw on second down. Finding time. It's hauled in by Shepard. And he's going to get this inside the 30. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. He had time, was able to survey the field and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field that you have to cover, and when the offense finds an area that you're not in, that's where they throw the football.
First carry here for Shane Vereen. And he's going to bring this one down to right about the 20-yard line. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. So we've reached the end of a fairly even first quarter of play. Nothing, nothing, our score. And we're back to Philadelphia after this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, and it's the Giants with a football here as we begin quarter number 2. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. Second down, here's Manning. It's complete. The tight end, Denell. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do. And it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
This is Jennings. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
One thing I know, defensive coaches love it when they don't have to invite their players to the party. This strong safety, you never have to ask him twice. To help in run support, he's going to arrive and in a bad mood.
And the 2-minute warning lurking. This will probably be the last play before we hit it.
Yeah, they want to get themselves in position to score in this last shot before the clock hits.
Now Manning throwing on second down. Hitting Denell here, the tight end right side. 1:58 to go in this first half of play. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. A reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll check in with Larry Ridley for highlights and analysis of our first half of play. Well, not too many highlights yet, at least in terms of scoring plays, that is.
Yeah, but hang in there. We might get something these last 2 minutes.
And on 3rd and 8, defensively, they're going to beef up the secondary. 6 defensive backs. Throwing is Manning on 3rd down. And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's 4th down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And Brown able to put it through. And the Giants are off now to a 3-0 lead. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
Now Brown, after the made field goal, gets set for the kickoff. On the return now, it's Josh Huff. Oh, nice spin.
Oh, that brought back bad memories.
They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. And this is Randall here over the middle. And he's brought down. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. And they're going to speed things up here. Bradford on first down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll go out of bounds. It appears right at the 45.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Second down, Bradford. The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And he's brought down. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
A first down throw for Bradford. And Matthews over the middle with a grab. It'll be a pickup of just two, and that'll make it second down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
Tight right, tight right. Flip, 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 flip.
They'll throw again, Bradford. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. 5 yards on the pickup, and they're going to face a third down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
And five in the secondary now for the Giants on third down. Again, it's Bradford. Aguilar has it. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes this one down to the 15. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
There we go now. Green 90.
From the red zone now, Bradford. This will be caught at about the 5. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen. but everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they show to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle. When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Bradford again. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. He was looking there for Reuben Randall. And that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal. The line of scrimmage is the three as they look to cash in on third and goal.
Here we go now. Blue 45. Blue 45.
Third and goal, Bradford. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Zach Ertz in the final seconds of the first half. And the Eagles are able to cash it in for six.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Well, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. Caleb Sturgis now for the point after. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. Now after the touchdown, it's Sturgis to send it away. The return man here, Dwayne Harris. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number one. So we've reached halftime here in a four-point game, as we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. Both teams have arguably played well enough to be leading at this point, but you see the score and realize this one may very well come down to the wire. Here we go. Let's do this. Here's your first half highlights. Now first and 10. It's Manning with the completion over the middle, and he'll end up picking up 18 yards on the play. Giants would stall out, though, and settle for a field goal. Third and goal. Here we'll get a pass into the end zone, and he'd cap off the 10-play drive with a TD. They're now on top by four. That'll do it from our EA Sports Studios. Let's send it back up to Brandon and Charles in Philadelphia.